Thank you so much, Manus Krani there. Now, if you were of a certain age in the 1980s,
not looking at Guy,
you probably danced the robot. But what if robots tried dancing like humans? Let's go over to our Middle East editor, Elliot Gotkin, in Tel Aviv to find out more. Elliot, I bet you did the robot.
I probably tried it once or twice, Francine, but I'm not sure I was very good. But I tell you one person who knows a little bit more about dancing the robot and robots dancing the human, I guess. It's Limor Schweitzer. He's the founder of Robo Savvy, and he joins me now. Thanks for coming in. And you've brought your little friend in. This is Fonzie, right?
Yes, it is. This is Fonzie. It's a robot that was designed originally in Korea for fighting competitions, and we have reprogrammed him to perform a dance.
Okay, he's got a special... Let's just see how Fonzie rocks, shall we? Because I know that this is the moment that everyone, especially Francine and Guy, have been waiting for. So we'll let him do his thing now.
Yeah. Yeah. When I'm on by, girls be looking like Danny Fly. I pick to the beat, walking down the street in my new the freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out of control. It's Red Bull with the big ass bro, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
When I walk in the spot, yeah, this is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it, show it, show it, show it.
Hey, Limor. So, this has to be the first kind of twerking robot I've ever seen. What's the point? Is this just all a bit of fun, or is there anything more serious going on here?
Well, it is a research platform. It is normally used for hobby and education and research. We have gotten him to with a choreographed dance, which has been extremely entertaining, and we've been presenting him in conferences around the world the past year.
This is just, I mean, the head here is 3D printed, but I know you're also developing the most advanced 1 meter tall research humanoid robot in the world, most of which is 3D printed.
Yes, we are developing a platform for researchers so that they can focus on human-robot interaction, and we provide them the engineered platform, which is a big humanoid robot that has very capable hands, very capable CPU power and vision.
And what other applications are we talking here? That you're not getting into robots just for dancing, presumably?
No, that's right. Today, the applications for humanoid robots are primarily in research. So there are some 3,000 robotists around the world, PhDs, that are researching robotics, and especially the walking and bipedal are still an open subject for research, very popular and very challenging.
Okay, now it's interesting. I mean, you're Israeli, it's a British company, but you're actually based in Portugal. I mean, given that we keep going on about technology in Israel, one would think that this would be the perfect place for you to be developing your robots. Why isn't it happening?
That's right. In fact, in Israel, there's a lot of venture capital, but the focus is primarily on software. And as we all know, hardware is a new software, but that hasn't quite reached Israel yet.
Okay, Limor Schweitzer, founder of Robo Savvy, and of course, Fonzie. From all of us, back to you in London.
Elliot, you have to promise me, you and also Fonzie and the owner have to get on the plane because we're throwing a party on Saturday night. And
yeah,
he has some moves.
It's going to be good. It's going to be good. That's just fantastic. In a more serious note, in a world of aging populations, these are the guys that are going to be doing the work.
Yeah, we hope.